Hi everybody, welcome. My name is Vicky Thornton. I'm a lecturer on the BA Performance Design and Practice course at Central St Martins. I specialise in teaching films. I'm delighted to welcome you to our screening today, Films of the Imaginarium. So it's a screening of short films by the BA Performance Design and Practice students that stimulates and cultivates the imagination. Demonstrating the diverse talents of our students through animation and moving image, these films celebrate the ingenuity and creativity of the next generation of artist filmmakers. From Metamorphosis and Mermaids to Jim Morrison and animated fauns, this screening will certainly pique your imagination. The students showing work in the programme today are Mallika Joy, Chelsea Formosa, Gabriella Engdahl, Georgia Gutbezahl, Grace Dunn, Florence Broomfield and Grace Capewell, Josephine James, Momo Sakai and Sam Cutbush. Welcome, hope you enjoy. Thanks a lot. Bye.
Once boys, become boys again in the cradle of my lap. One golden thread proves enough to bind them to the contours of softest skin. My darkest caverns concealed from the pleasure of the light, until rough hands set me aflame. May I touch you there, and there? The primitive never left. How could it when it's there, captive and centuries old in your eyes? My nakedness dug it up, as my nakedness now repels it. You're no artifact to be unearthed and held close. Just as mother told me to leave what is dead, buried. Even the most solid of forms melt under my kind words. Every move made, word spoken, and breeze taking, determined by a different kind of flesh to mine.
Thank you. Thank you. Shh.
Thank you.
To make a lifelong story short, I never considered my body to be mine. It was always some sort of product of the people observing it. Of you. A product packaged and ready to be sent off, square and pointy, wrapped in silk paper and bruises. Just like you wanted it. Let me tell you something else as a part of this very short and astounding story of mine. This dressing room that I get dressed in every day steals my food, and I am positive my choreographer is aware of it. I know it sounds out of this world maniac, but it's not. It truly is a thief. And for the record, it's not just mine, but also Sarah's, Why is this not a piece of world news? For all I know, you don't care. Straight lines, long neck, smiley face, pointy shoulders, slim outlook, white skin, symmetrical face, extended knees, present outlook. Did that sound perfect to you?
Psst! Aren't we supposed to be in a box?
Well, we kind of are. Anyway, your gaze is nothing but a product of society, and my body was never mine. It was yours. It is yours. Everybody's. Let the dressing room eat. Tell my choreographer. Or actually, he knows. I am fine.
Thank you. So you swallow a microchip, and then every time you put the wings on, it activates them and you can fly.
Okay.
And I can remove them when I want to.
Doesn't that sound a bit like, I don't know, unnatural?
There has to be a catch,
Morpho.
I really don't think so. I had a long look and everything seems to make sense.
But how much is it though? Something like that must cost a fortune.
Well, it's on a contract, which actually happens to be discounted at the moment because they're like still trying things out.
So you'd be like a guinea pig?
Well, no, not necessarily. I have experimented on other people already. Could you imagine if I had wings, Violet? If I could actually fly?
Well, I guess you'd be the fairy that you were destined to be.
Hi, is that Metamorphosis? Hi, I'm calling to make an order. That's okay. It's 5th of August, 2026.
Hello, Caterpillar. If you're reading this, then it's time for your metamorphosis. As you should know by now, your wings only function when paired to your unique microchip, which has to be inside the body. For this to happen, you must swallow the microchip with water, like you would a pill. Let it work its magic overnight, but try and wear the wings as much as possible in the meantime, so they can adjust to your body, much like a real butterfly, after its emergence from the chrysalis. Taking flight straight away is strongly discouraged, but when it is time, the chip will provide you with natural instinct, so no need to overthink it. Thank you for flying with Metamorphosis.
Oh my god, I can't believe it. What was it like?
To fly. It felt like nothing that I'd ever felt before. Oh, it's them. Hello? Oh yeah, that's fine. They're just doing a few follow-up questions, if you don't mind.
No. Go ahead.
Everything went really well. Yeah, I loved it. Yeah, I feel that. Yeah, if you email that to me. Yeah. Yeah. I think so.
Warning, wing lifespan has reached completion. Thank you for flying with Mermaids. Thank you. Kevin is wiping his eyes, getting all that sleep out, and now he's stretching. Kevin always loves his morning stretch. Kevin pulls his covers off to start the day and get out of bed. Kevin always says the best way to start the day is by making your bed. Ta-da! And that's Kevin's bed finished.
Kevin picks up the kettle and takes it to the sink to fill it up with water. Kevin then puts the kettle back and flicks the switch on to boil the water.
Kevin opens the cover to get a mug to make his cup of coffee. This is Kevin's favorite mug and he uses it every morning. Kevin puts in 2 teaspoons of coffee. Kevin loves that caffeine fix. Kevin pours his water in. Kevin pours his milk in. And ta-da! Kevin's made his perfect cup of coffee. Kev's first sig of the day is always with a cup of coffee in the morning. Kev says, there's no better way to start the day than a cup of coffee and a cig in the morning. A cigarette and coffee clearly wasn't too friendly on Kev's bowels, and now Kevin needs to go number 2. Kevin grabs his toilet paper, and one thing Kevin always says is, don't forget to wipe properly. Kevin flushes the toilet. This is Kevin's daily toothpaste that he uses. Kevin says, it might not be the best for you as it's got fluoride in it. And we all know fluoride's not the best for you. But Kevin says he's on a budget and it does the job. Kevin puts toothpaste on his toothbrush and Kevin brushes his teeth. Kevin always says, make sure you brush your teeth well, kids, because that's how you get them the most shiny. Brush, 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 brush away.
And that's how you get the perfect pearly whites. Kevin is very sad because it's raining outside and now he can't go on an adventure. Kevin starts to think, what is it that he can do today since he's having a rainy day in? So he thinks, oh, that's a good one. Kevin decides painting is the first activity that he wants to do today. Kevin gets his paints ready. The first color that Kevin is going to go for is blue. Then Kevin chooses yellow. Then he goes for pink. And his final color, orange. Kevin starts painting. First, he starts with the eyes by doing them orange. Kevin loves painting. He always says his favorite approach is always going with his intuition. Kevin says this way of working, he always finds the most fun and rewarding and thinks it's the best way to get those creative juices going. And he recommends that everyone just picks up a paintbrush and just goes with it. Kevin always says, don't worry about others understanding your work. As long as you enjoy doing it, that's all that matters. And ta-da! That's Kevin's painting done. Everyone clap for Kevin!
Kevin now wants to play dress up. So Kevin obviously came to get me, you know, of course, the most fashionable of them all, eh, Kevin? Besides you.
Kev's first look, he's gone for a raincoat.
Okay, so for Kev's next look, he wants to go for the pimp look, so we're gonna make him a pimp.
Ta-da! Kev loves his pimp look. For Kev's final look, he's gone for a green fur coat. And that is the dressing show at Kev finished. Kevin's had a very long day of being fabulous, so now it's sleepy time, so he can get ready and do it all again tomorrow. Good night, Kevy boy.
Let's pretend to be like marshmallow man. some more.
Marshmallows!
Marshmallows!
Ooh!
Ah, this could be you!
One day you'll be a marshmallow too!
Unless you change! Change! Change!
One, two, three.